In this video, we're going to go over reports. Clicking the Reports tab will take you here. You can cycle between the old Reports view and the new Reports view depending on which type of reports you wish to view. Seeing how they cover the same information, we're going to use the new view for this tutorial. By clicking on the column on the left, you'll be able to view reports by their date, so you can cycle to the day to view the individual reports, or click on the deck below to see all the students that have played it and their scores. We're going to go over two of the students now and see how they got the scores and explain what the categories mean. The first student is going to play the deck and get every question correct. When students play a deck, we're not only tracking whether or not they got the answers, but how much time. So if a student takes a longer amount of time on a card, you'll be able to know once they're done with the deck. The first student got all of the questions correct, and looks like they've earned some badges. Now that the students completed it, we can see it under their list of completed decks, showing both a full green circle and the four gems, meaning they got all four questions correct. If you scroll down on an individual student's page, you can see all of their recent plays, as well as what level they are. Let's check in with student number two. They're going to play the same deck as the first student. Unfortunately, due to their speed, they get a question wrong. No problem, once they get the right question, they're still able to move on and complete the deck. Now that they're done, you'll see they got one less gem. If they wish to play the game again, they can click so here to get 100%, or they can go back to the home as they've completed the deck. When we compare the two students, we're able to see that they both have completed one play and answered four questions. The difference is, one of them only got 3 out of 4 correct. Let's have student two go back and replay again, see if they can't get 100% this time. It's always easier the second time. Now we can see they got all four gems, and when you go back to the reports, you'll see they have 2 total plays. And now, they can see the mastery score is equal to 4-4, meaning they've completed every card in the deck. We can see their average is lower than their best. This is because the average pulls from the most recent 3 plays, while the last play pulls from just the most recent. As long as their best score is 100%, you'll know they've completed it. As the other students fill in, you'll be able to see other scores. Remember, if you ever get confused about any of this, at the bottom of the page, there's a handy breakdown of what each of these tabs mean. Let's go over the export feature real quick, in case you ever need to share your student report data. Clicking the export document will allow you to download an Excel file that will break down all of your student reports data into a handy file that you can take and share with the student's parents, if need be. All the data will be broken down into the same categories here. One last thing. At the very bottom of the reports page, there's a link that will take you to our FAQ. This will cover in depth everything we talked about today and so much more. Try not to get overwhelmed, as there is a lot of information we haven't had a chance to cover. Like batches, anytime you assign a deck that has more than 20 cards, we only assign 20 cards of the deck to the student to play. This means that if a student plays subsequent games, they will get more cards filtered in until they've played every card in the deck. This is just one of the many features that you can control and learn to use to customize Boom Learning to your student's experience to meet your needs. Thank you so much for using Boom.